we in Ghana have a very vibrant media. Indeed, we pride ourselves as having the most vibrant and the most independent media in the whole of Africa. And I'm sure you've been here for quite some time, and you've had opportunity to monitor the media, both electronic and print. And you find that on a daily basis, government is subjected to intense scrutiny over a broad range of issues. And we are happy to encourage that atmosphere that allows media personnel to express themselves freely, to investigate issues that they find interesting. In fact, media freedoms are enshrined in our constitution, and so practitioners in that sector draw inspiration from that. But vibrancy does not necessarily translate into professionalism. And we do have a situation where many people join the media fraternity as a last resort. There are people who perhaps have been unsuccessful in other endeavors and find solace in the media. And so you have situations where people are not really trained to engage in a profession, but try to learn on the job. That has its own limitations, because often ethics and professionalism are sacrificed on the altar of the pursuit of a right to free speech and what have you, and the pursuit of a right to a decent livelihood. So the challenge really is to ensure that media practitioners carry out their trade in a manner that does not undermine the ethics of the profession, that does not gloss over the need to be professional, the need to be balanced, the need to be accurate in reportage, and all that. Another challenge is that we do not have enough specialization in various fields. Many people practice generally news, especially sensational and political stories. There's very little specialization in terms of education, health, environment, social issues, gender, human rights, and other such related matters. In recent times too, we ensure that activities regarding the president get to the Ghanaian public on a more sustainable basis. And this is to ensure that we develop in a comprehensive and holistic fashion as a country. And the role of information cannot be underestimated in any developmental process. Indeed, if you speak to people in Latin America and other places, they will tell you that development communication played a key role in lifting them from the doldrums into a place where they can now boast of a certain measure of comfort. In the past, governments have not been too keen on sharing information with the citizenry, and we know that we are moving into an age where people crave on a daily basis for information, and the advent of social media and other such technologies makes it possible for information to be shared around in rapid fashion. So any government that is unwilling to open up, subject itself to scrutiny, and provide information on a consistent basis to its citizenry stands the risk of incurring the wrath of the people that it presides over. And we are determined to ensure that we do not place the Ghanaian citizens in a situation where they have to crave or thirst for information when we can do something about it.